Hotline, former linebacker for both the Hawai'i Rainbow Warriors and the St. Louis Rams, Pisa Tinoisamoa. Pisa, thanks for coming by.
Thanks for having me on. I appreciate that.
You do a lot of, I notice a lot of these things. You make appearances, you give your time. I think it's fabulous. I know not everybody does that, but you've obviously chosen to stay involved with the youth, with community outreach events, and with your former teams.
Well, you know, growing up, I was fortunate enough to be around some, you know, some major players, Junior Seau, and growing up in San Diego. And so for me, it was only natural after I was done playing to go ahead and do the same thing that I was taught. So to be able to do these events on behalf of the Rams and the Warriors as well, it just seems like my duty.
I don't know if you can name, there's a third player that absolutely has your pedigree and Greg Salas's, playing for the Rainbow Warriors and also for the Rams. Do you happen to know who that third player is?
Is it Kalana Noah?
He actually, this is funny because someone brought him up. Kalana Noah never got past the practice squad. So we're not counting him.
Okay.
But
I got one.
You got one?
I got one.
Okay.
Wayne Hunter.
Did he play for the Rams too?
Oh.
I didn't know he played for the Rams.
He actually did.
Wow, see, there you go. He's a fourth one. Because you may have met him along the way, because after his playing career with the Rams, he went on to become a player, an agent. And that is former offensive lineman Leo Goas.
Oh.
And you probably knew him. I'm sure you do. So anyway, but it's amazing. I don't know if there's any other NFL team that could represent four players that played at UH and on one particular NFL franchise. That's amazing.
I think we should write that down.
Absolutely. I won't forget it again.
The Rams are the official team of Hawaii.
There you go. I think you could make a case. You could make an argument, which is kind of good stuff. Let me just get this from you, because I know it's preseason, and I know players look at preseason a little differently, and so do coaches. For some players, I mean, this is life or death on tomorrow.
Right.
Because guys are just really desperately hoping. If you're like in that last 10 and trying to make it a special team, trying to get an active roster spot, I know when you started playing, I don't think the first year player salary was anywhere near what it is now, which is about almost a half a million.
Right, not at all. It was probably half of that.
Yeah, I mean, it's really changed. You must look, every player who's...
I'm not complaining, by the way.
I got you, but once you're 5 or 7 years out, you probably look back and say, holy smokes, I was born too soon.
That's why I try not to, because I don't have to deal with those frustrations.
I hear you, man. But I do think that what's happened is the players and the back ends of teams are... This is huge. Preseason becomes unbelievably... For the first line players, as you were when you were at the Rams, I mean, this is just getting ready for the season, right?
Right, yeah, it's definitely a tune-up for the veterans.
Yeah.
You know, a good time, at least, that's how I try to approach it. I wanted to get trending in the right direction before season started, and so preseason was a great opportunity to do that. When I was younger in my career, it definitely was a time for me to prove that I was worthy and worth that second-round draft pick.
Sure.
And so, you know, there was a lot of debate even back then when I was playing about whether guys were good enough. And so, you know, when you're dealing with so many guys, you know, the macho, the alpha males, you know, you stick them all in one room and on one field, you can't help but to compete. And so for me, I always had a different approach when I would play that. I would always want to like prove something, especially coming from a small school. We were in the WAC back then, and
sure,
you know, I always wanted to prove that, hey, I'm good enough to play. So I tried to use that time to you know, when I'm on the field, I'm playing. It's nothing about, oh, this is preseason, you know, because if you put it on film, you know, it's there and it's always being evaluated. And that's what you learn when you're in the NFL, is that, you know, if you take plays off, that's
done. They'll know.
They'll know.
Yeah.
And that's not going to help your cause if you're trying to negotiate further down the line.
Well, I don't even know if you guys have ever met, but what's interesting is Hawai'i had another second-round draft pick this year, played linebacker,
right,
and he's a Southern California guy. He's of Polynesian descent, and Jelani Tavai, now with the Detroit Lions. I remember people saying, what a reach. I don't know. What we're hearing out of Detroit Lions camp is he's a tackling machine, but we saw that. We knew that. But it's funny because he has said a lot of the same things you're saying. It's about every snap. I mean, you have to prove yourself every single play.
Right, and I was fortunate actually to meet Jelani during the pre-draft, pre-combine stuff.
Yeah.
I'm actually a trainer, a linebacker trainer for Exos Sports Performance.
Fabulous.
And so he was at the facility, and you know, I was coaching the linebackers, and I knew of him.
Right.
But I never got to see him up close and personal, and I can tell you, just being around him, I could see why the hype was so high about him.
Yeah.
Because he not only is like good size, and he had that hype, but he actually is a good character guy. I got to learn, like, this guy's really bright. And I know, you know, Matt Patricia, Bill Belichick, those guys, they don't pull stupid guys off the, you know, they don't just draft stupid guys.
In fact, what the rumor was, that the reason that Matt Patricia was, because he was, they had a certain style of guy they wanted. They wanted big, and they wanted diverse, and could do several things. And he seemed to fit the bill, and they were worried about, it's funny you mentioned Belichick and Patricia, because Patricia is now, of course, with the Lions, but they were afraid Belichick was going to take him late in the second round, so they felt they had no choice. They had to pull the trigger.
That's awesome.
And he ended up going, I think, number 42 overall, which was higher. We'd see a ton of fourth round and fifth round projections, but going in the second round, well, first of all, it makes for a nicer payday.
Right.
But I also think he seemed much like you. He was an energy guy. He's a great motor and someone that you don't have to teach to give your best effort on every play.
And he was, I think he was still raw. You know, I got to learn that he was a rugby player, you know, all through high school, came here, played, and so tackling machine, not surprising. But I was actually surprised about how athletic he was at his size.
Yeah.
Because I'm smaller than him. So.
He's 250.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And he's taller than
6'3", 250, which is, yeah. What did you weigh at your, what was your heaviest playing weight, either in college or pro?
It was 235.
That's what I was going to guess, yeah.
And I didn't like that weight. You know, I was told, hey, perception is reality, so you want to, you know, be heavier because you're shorter. I was, you know, barely 6 foot. Right. And so they're like, okay, you have to be 6 foot, 230 to fit in that range to be draftable. And, you know, they like to see that. But I actually, you know, I like playing lighter. You know, I like
playing because you're faster.
Exactly. And so my thing was speed. And when I was heavier, I didn't have the speed or agility that I was comfortable and I like. So not until later in my career, once I started to get smarter about things, you know, was I able to go ahead and drop that weight.
Right. So 225, live with it, folks.
Exactly. You know, if you want the production, this is what it's going to have to be. So eventually, you know, they were able to accept that.
See their way.
Yeah.
Which is great. But I whenever I see, I mean, all of us, I think when you were playing, certainly for me, if you had a chance to call Hawaii players games, you're rooting for them. I mean, and I think that's true in the state generally. We root for our own. And once you put on, you know, the green here, I mean, then you're one of, you know, I think forever, you'll be one of Hawaii. I know you're a California guy, but you'll always be Hawaii. White people consider you one of those.
And I feel it, you know, especially being back and doing these events. And that's why I don't, you know, I love doing these events back on the island because I felt like I came here as a high school kid, lots of trouble.
Yeah.
And I left here, you know, a strong, balanced, more loving man. And so I felt like Hawaii was a reason for that. You know, I was able to kind of merge those two personalities. And so, you know, I felt so indebted to the island and so appreciative of all the love they showed me.
I do remember when, because June Jones had a reputation, he'd find out about somebody, he'd been in San Diego, and he kind of found out a little bit about the family situation, the whole thing, and he said, we're going to take a chance on this guy. He goes, and I'm not worried about him. And never in your Hawaii career did anyone have any cause to be worried about you. A great citizen and a fabulous player. And I think what you're doing now proves that he was right. You were all of that.
Thank you. And that's I didn't want to let him down.
Yeah.
And definitely being out here helped get me away from the environment that I was in and allowed me to flourish. And that's something that I'll never forget.
Well, you've done fabulously in your career. Now you're going across the street to a work over with these youngsters.
Yes. Yep. Headed across the street. We're going to do some sports activities with the kids.
That's great.
You know, on behalf of the ASB and I-9 Sports, you know, is hosting as well, and the Rams. And so, you know, just an honor to go ahead and share with these kids and, you know, hopefully bring some more of that energy.
I got to tell you, it's great to see you again. You're in fighting trim. You look terrific, and I wish you the best of luck. Thanks so much
for
coming by. Pisa Tinoisamoa, who is helping here with the Rams.